All right, boys and girls, welcome back. Tone King here, coming at you live from the Tone Lounge. Video I'd like to do today, I've done this in the past, but it's been so long, and I do this pretty frequently. It's been so long, I figured I would do a refresh, okay? I have a Floyd Rose, and I want to change the tuning on my guitar. How do I do it? Well, it's actually really simple. Basically, you know, there's a couple of tricks where you could get it real quick, and I'm going to show you how to do that. So my guitar is plugged directly into this tuner over here, and you could see over here, you know, I'm fairly in tune. That's my E, A, D, G, B, A. So let's say I want to tune down half a step. Basically, what I have to do is, what I want to do, I need the trem arm first. Let me get the trem arm to here. Because I have to pull that up a little bit. I actually never put the trem on. Well, maybe I did put the trem on in here. I don't remember. Actually, I don't think I did. Let me get the trem arm for this guitar. Let me throw that bad boy in here. And you need the trem arm because what I'm going to do here, I'm going to lift this up a little bit. And I want to throw some business cards. Some people, you know, make wooden blocks and all that. But basically, I want to throw some cards in there. Just like that. So it's basically going to support it from going up or down, okay? And that supports that. Second thing I want to do, I have to undo my locking nuts up here. So that's one, two, and three. Okay? So you want to make sure those are loose. So now my bridge, my Floyd is supported by some business cards, and then my locking nuts are off. And then the third thing I want to do is, over here, you see these things over here? I want to put them right in the middle. So I don't want them to be too high. I don't want them to be screwed in too low. I want them right in the middle. So I'm going to take a look at the back. I'm going to eyeball it. And I want to put these right in the middle. And if you're not sure, so see, as an example, right over here, you could see my high E is way low compared to the other ones. See that? That's what happens over time when you keep tuning your guitar. But I'm gonna start from scratch because I'm gonna tune it. And basically, what I want to do is I want to get them all nice and even. Now, if you're not sure like how high or how low, basically you take one, you put it all the way high, the other one all the way low, third one in the middle, and then you put all the other ones like the third one in the middle. That's probably the easiest thing to do. And if you want to see what I'm talking about, I could show you. I'll do it just for you. Okay, so you could do something like this, where you take one, make it real high, the other one real low, and then that one will be right in the middle between the high and the low, and the other ones, then you have to put them all in the middle. And that just gives you enough travel room to go flat or sharp on the fine tuning. So you want them all nice and right in the middle, okay? And you could see over here, they are all nice and right in the middle, okay? You should be able to rest something flat across the top of those. Now, basically now what I have to do, by the way, something you should do right now, stretch your strings, because if the strings aren't stretched, you'll keep going out of tune. Basically, I take an old dirty rag, and I pinch it. So I'm basically going like this. So I take an old dirty rag and I take the string and basically I stretch the string. So it's hard for me to explain this one. Basically what I'm doing is, let's say this pencil is a string. I'm pushing down with this and pushing up as you go across the string because it stretches the string. Okay, and I'm gonna do that. Now may even be a good time to clean the string if you really wanted to. Okay, but basically just wanted to give it a little stretch, and the strings are actually pretty good already. And then now I'm gonna tune my guitar. So keep your eye on the tuner. And so I'm at C sharp and I wanna be at about D sharp. So I'm gonna bring it up a little bit. And the way I tune Floyd Rose tuners all the time, we'll do it together. Write this down. Low E first, then the high E. And then B, the B string. And then the A. And then the G, because basically you're creating balance. And then the D string. Now it should be in pretty good tune because remember I fixed the bridge, right? So I'm going to check it one more time. Nope, it wants to do all the strings. Here we go. D. Actually, it was all a little flat. And then you keep going in that order. So you do the low E, high E, the high B, A, G, D. And basically I'm right there. That was it, right? So then, you know, play it, make sure it held its tune. You know why that's off? Because I'm using chromatic mode and I'm tuned down half a step. But let's do that. No, I don't want to do all the strings. I just want to do... There's my D. There I am. So now what you do, the next step, you tighten up the locking nuts. One, two, and three. So, and then the last step, after you tighten the locking nuts, once you remove those business cards, it's going to be thrown out of whack a little bit. Watch. So I remove the business cards. And you see, now I'm high, but now what you do, I'm not high like that, I mean the string tuning is high. See, now it's showing high E, but now what you do, because it's all set, that's where the back comes into play. You will take a Phillips head screwdriver, and you will pull it back a little bit until you're in tune, and that's it. And that's why a lot of, like, especially hot-rodded guitars don't have the back cover on. So watch this. I'm going to tune that. And I want to bring that down to A sharp. Watch this. Bring the whole thing down a little bit. I meant to say D sharp, by the way. There you go. Oh, can you see it in there? Boom. We're almost there. We are almost there. Almost there. There we go. A little bit more. Look at that. And there it is. We are officially, we drop tune the Floyd. So check this out. This is my G. And then you could fine tune it. You could drop this a little bit right here, like that, until you're right on the money. That's it. You have your bridge nice and flush against the body. And by the way, in case you're wondering what screws I was talking about, these screws right here. The whole reason why you have two screws, once you set it up, you could go in or out. In our case, we had to pull it out a little bit. And that's it. I just drop tune my ML1. And look at that. Look how nice and flush and flat that is. The trem. That's on the money. And by the way, I didn't edit this video. Not edited. When you could do that, do exactly what I did without, you know, taking too long, you've mastered the science. And again, let's go through the steps again. You want to secure the trem. You want to undo here. You want to stretch the strings. Tune it up here to the pitch that you want. And then you want to keep tuning it in the order of low E, high E, high B, low A, G, and then the D string. You keep doing that until it's in tune. When you feel comfortable with that, you lock the locking nuts, you pull the business cards away, and then you fine-tune the tuning by moving these screws in or out. And then when you're basically there, you fine-tune it right here. And that's it. That is how you drop-tune or up-tune a guitar that has a Floyd Rose. Unedited. That's it. That's all I have for you. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. Leave you off with one of those. Thanks for watching as always. And until next time, rock on. Later.